Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Ali here from the Source Park. Another day, another empty car park, and today I'm going to teach you how to do a bunny hop on a... No, I'm not teaching you how to bunny hop. I've already done that. I'm going to teach you how to do a manual on a BMX. Okay, first thing I want to cover in this video, because a lot of people get confused with this, is the difference between a manual and a wheelie. Okay, so both tricks involve balancing on your back wheel and having your front wheel up in the air. But the difference between a manual and a wheelie is that when you're in a wheelie, you're pedaling. So when you're pedaling, it's accelerating the back wheel, which keeps the front wheel up. But in a manual, you're just balancing. So you're using all of your body to help balance the bike, and you're not using pedaling to assist you. If you saw my how to manual video on a skateboard on Monday, this is going to be pretty similar, because the thing with manuals is it's just practicing. So I'm going to tell you how to do it and how to get your wheel up and kind of keep the balance, but then that's it. Then you've just got to practice. You've got to go out there and just do them. First things first, you need to find a good space to do the manuals. So like a big open space, because you kind of want to get a little bit of speed to do them, because the slower you go, the harder they are to balance and keep up. So you want to have a nice open space where you can get a nice long straight run. First thing you want to do for a manual then is to pick your front wheel up. So I'm going to quickly go over that with you, but I did go over it in the bunny hop tutorial last week, so you can watch that if you need some more tips on it. So you're going to want to compress down and bend your arms and put your weight forwards to then sort of catapult yourself backwards, straighten your arms and pull your wheel back. So you're throwing all your weight back while yanking the handlebars up. So that's going to get your front wheel up. So something you should practice before you start doing manuals, because this is definitely going to happen to you at some point, is looping out. You're going to end up pulling the bike and going too far, and you're going to end up looping out. And if you're not ready for that, you're going to end up on your back. So a good thing to do is just to go along and just yank the bike up and just jump to land on your feet. And just keep doing that over and over and over again, because then when you are in a manual and it just comes out of nowhere, you're going to be ready for it and you're going to land on your feet rather than on your butt. Now you've practiced bailing out a few times and you're comfortable with that, so you know when you are in a manual and if it does go wrong, you're going to be able to save yourself. The next thing you need to do is be able to understand where your balance is going to be. So as soon as you pull your handlebars up off the ground, you want to be shifting all of your weight back. You kind of want to be sitting over your back wheel, because if your weight's over your handlebars and you're leaning forward, it's going to be almost impossible to keep the bike up. It's going to be wanting to go down and you're not going to be able to stop it. When I first started doing manuals, in my head for some reason, I just thought it was all in your arms. So I thought you were pulling the bike up and controlling it all with your arms, but I was so wrong. It's actually nothing to do with your arms. As soon as the bike's up, your arms should just be locked, and then it's your legs that's controlling it. You're almost pumping to keep the bike up. So every time you straighten your legs, the front wheel's going up, and then every time you pull your legs in, the wheel's going down. So you're using that to control the front wheel and make sure that you can balance as long as possible. Right, so you're going to be leaning forwards, compressing yourself, bending your arms, getting ready to pull back. And then you're going to pull back, straighten your arms, shift all of your weight backwards. Like I said, have your butt over your back seat almost, so you're sitting over it. All of your weight backwards and your arms locked straight. And then from there on, it's just with your legs, you're going to be pumping the bike to try and keep it up. When I first started trying manuals, I remember they were impossible. I couldn't even keep my wheel up for a second. It was so hard to keep it up. But it's just one of those things you just need to repeat over and over and over again. And they're so easy, you can do them anywhere. Wherever you're riding, you can always try a manual. So the more work you put into them, the more you're going to get out of them. Like I said, these aren't going to come easy. It's going to take a long time for you to master that balance and be able to hold it for, I don't know, even like 5 seconds. It's going to take some time to get there. So it's good to give yourself targets. Like, that's why I always come to car parks when I'm practicing stuff like manuals, because parking spaces are the best for measuring. If you can do one parking space, then you're going to try two parking spaces and then three, and then eventually you'll be doing the whole car park. So if you're doing manuals and you've set yourself a target, say you're manualing five parking spaces or a long ledge, a good tip is the second you go into the manual, just stare at where you're going. Rather than staring at your bike or staring at the floor, just look ahead at where you're going, and it'll really help you get there. If you've got the hang of manuals now and you're balancing them for quite a while, if you want a bit of a challenge, try and do a bunny hop into a manual or a bunny hop out of a manual. Like I said, the possibilities are endless with manual, so whatever tricks you can do, try into them or try out of them. So that's about it really. It was only going to be a quick one today, just like the skate one. Once you've got the basics down, you just need to practice yourself. Just go out and practice. And like I said, manuals can be practiced anywhere. So wherever you are, as long as you're on your bike, you can practice manuals. I'll see all you guys on the next video. I hope you're staying safe.